So this video is going to be different than what I usually film and upload. This is a lot more serious and personal of a video, but I'm still gonna try and keep it positive and happy. I've been wanting to make this video for about a year now, and I don't know, I just kept telling myself that it wasn't the right time. But there's been a couple things lately that's happened that I just feel like it's time to talk about it. I'm really nervous and I also don't want to cry in this video. So just bear with me if it's choppy or if like I'm all over the place. A couple weeks ago, my friend Sebastian was talking to me and he really encouraged me to talk about it. And that was kind of the first thing that I was like, okay, maybe I, you know, should really think about talking about it. So the second thing that happened was I was watching a video that some people made for my birthday.
I love Jess Conte because of how open she is with her fans. She stays honest with us 100% of the time, and she's not afraid to share the parts of her life that aren't always the easiest. I respect and look up to her so much for that because it's a huge reminder that we aren't alone.
That kind of really hit me, going like, they think I'm so honest with them, but like the biggest thing in my life right now, I'm not telling anyone. And then I talked to my manager, I talked to my parents, and of course I talked to Gabe, and everyone thought that it was a good time to talk about it. I know that was a really long intro, but I just wanted to kind of explain that, like why I'm explaining it now. I guess another thing I want to say before I fully get into it is that I'm not making this video for attention, and I'm not making it for sympathy. Like, I don't want people to feel bad for me. Like, I don't want any of that. I just really want to share what's going on. If you guys don't know, I am from Australia and I live in Los Angeles. I've lived here since January 5th, 2017. I moved here after I married my husband Gabe, and we got married in Australia and then moved here. That was the last time that we've been to Australia, which was a year and a half ago. And we get questions probably every week, like, when are you going to Australia? Or why haven't you gone back to Australia yet? Or are you doing an Australian tour? Just like, we get a lot of questions, especially I get a lot of questions about when I'm going back home, when I'm going to go visit my family. And especially if I like post on social media that I miss Australia or I miss like something about Australia, there's always at least one person that's like, well, just go back then. But I can't. Basically, I am not a resident in America yet. And that is a process that takes a lot of time. And basically, until you're a resident, you can't leave the country. So we are still going through the residency process. It's been a year and a half. Until I get my residency, I won't be able to not only go back to Australia, but we can't leave the country at all. Well, Gabriel can, but I can't. So that is like, long story short, that's like basically it. And I feel like a lot of people might already know, but majority of people mustn't know because we just get so many questions. Even like, when are you going to visit the UK? Or like, we just get a lot of questions about going out of the country. It's just been something that's been very, very difficult for me, and difficult for me and Gabriel as a newly married couple. Like, that's a really tough thing to go through together straight away. I can't cry in this video because I know my parents are gonna watch and my mom's gonna cry if I cry, so I can't cry right now. I kind of want to explain this thing, this side thing, really quickly. There's this thing called advanced parole, which means you apply for it when you start your application, and advanced parole basically means that you can leave the country and come back in even though you're not a resident yet. Basically, we didn't get told that that was a thing until I researched and found it out myself, and then by the time we applied for it, it was too late. So technically, I have this document called advanced parole, which means technically I could leave, but I might not be allowed back in. And so our attorney just said, like, don't risk it. If I'm not, I think it's like 3 years, at least 3 years, that I wouldn't be allowed back in. So that's just like a risk that we can't take. But that itself was really hard. I felt like my prayers were being answered and that I was finally going to be able to travel back home. I feel like now I've said that, people it'll make sense in people's minds, like why my family have only come here, why my friends have only come to me and I haven't gone to them yet. One of the reasons why I was so nervous to film this video was because I didn't want people thinking that I was ungrateful for the life that I'm living at the moment. I'm really nervous to like read people's comments about this because I am so blessed to live the life that I do and to have the job that I do, to live in the city that I live in. Every single person has a different struggle that they're going through and this is mine, so I've been praying and praying that this is just taken really well and that I don't come across ungrateful. I also still, although I'm sharing this, I still do want to ask for privacy with it because it's something really emotional and it's like the hardest thing that I've ever had to go through. So I just hope you guys are able to watch this video and listen to what I have to say, but just still give me privacy with it. It's not something that I like talking about. And maybe the way that I'm explaining this doesn't make it seem that hard. I'm still trying to keep this video kind of positive, so it might come across like I'm not struggling or that it's not a difficult process, but it's the hardest thing that I've ever had to go through. And I have kept quiet about it for so long, a year and a half, because it is such an emotional thing and it is so hard to go through. When things move forward with it and when I get my residency and when I'm able to travel, I'm gonna tell you guys straight away. I'm going to be so excited and just so relieved. I know also, like, I'm not the only one that's ever gone through this. I'm sure there are so many other people going through this right now, but it really does make you feel alone. Gabe as well has been, he's been amazing through this journey. Obviously, it's really hard on him too, and really hard for him to see me going through something that's really hard. He's been so understanding and so comforting, and he's just been really the best. It's also been really hard on my family too. It's just like a super emotional thing to go through, and I know I've probably said that 30 times already, but to put it in perspective, I never moved out of home. All my life I lived at home. When I went to university, I lived at home. When I was engaged to Gabriel, I lived at home. So my first time moving out of home was when I moved across the world. So obviously you can imagine it's been so hard on my family as well, especially my mom. I feel like, I hope she's okay with me saying that, but my mom is an emotional soul. I think that's where I get it from. And yeah, it's been really hard on her emotionally, but I think she's getting better. Mom, you're doing good. You're getting better. I think that's also been hard on me as well, like knowing that it's hard for my family and like when they get emotional, like I kind of force myself to be the strong one. I remember when I first moved here, every FaceTime that I would do with my mom, she would cry, and I'd always just have to be like, Mom, come on, don't be silly, we're okay, I'll talk to you later, and like just be positive and like be the strong one because it has been hard on everyone. I think during this, most of all, I don't want to cry, this has played a huge part in my faith. I think sometimes I just get so confused and so upset that I'm like, God, why are you making me wait this long, and like why can't I just go back? Why does it have to be like this? But I know that everything happens for a reason. I know that God's timing is perfect. So I know that he's going to bless me with my residency someday soon. And although it doesn't make sense to me right now, I know that one day it will make sense. Something that I've learned during this season of my life is that God can use you in seasons of trouble. That also may sound confusing, like how could he use me right now? Maybe even me making this video will help someone. Maybe someone who watches my videos is also going through the same thing. That would be crazy. But maybe it will help them to not feel so alone. Something else that I learned is that God is with you in dark seasons and in dark moments. Like God is still there, and it's something that I learned about in church a couple weeks ago, that even in the darkness God is with you. I think that's a really comforting reminder. I want you guys to know that like what you see on social media is, I know you hear this a lot, but like a highlight reel, and that's so clearly true. Like I have been hiding this part of my life on social media for a year and a half. Like you might look at my Instagram and be like, wow, she's so happy all the time, but I want you guys to know that that's not the case, and that's also okay. I'm not always happy. There'll be days where I just need to like switch off. If any of you guys are going through the same thing, please please let me know on Twitter or in the comments below. I think it would be really comforting for me to know. With immigration and residency and getting a green card, you have to put in so much. Like when we put in my application, we put in so much stuff. We put in our YouTube channel that where we vlog together. We put in pictures of me with his family and pictures of Gabe with my family. We put in letters from friends confirming the relationship was true. Like they just ask you to put in so much to kind of prove the relationship. And I thought we put in so much stuff, and like our YouTube channel that we vlog on all the time. Like I did not expect it to take this long. When we first started the whole process, we were told that it would take this amount of months, and then that amount of months passed, and then we were told, okay, it'll take like this many more months, and then that passed. And we've just been told so many different things now that my heart is just like so confused, and it's just like now I just wait. I guess I didn't even really explain like the process of what happens. So you put in your application and then you kind of just wait, and there's stuff that you're meant to apply for, like I said about events parole, that we didn't know about, so we didn't do. The next step for me was biometrics. So that's getting like your fingerprints and your pictures and just everything, like your biometrics taken. And then from then you get an interview, and that's what we're waiting on right now. And the interview is like the final step. And then after the interview, maybe like a week or 2 weeks or a day, or it could be like in the interview, you either get approved or they need to ask you more questions. That's when you get approved, is after the interview. So we are so close to the end. But in saying that, because it's been a year and a half, it just feels like it's never gonna come. I know I just need to keep trusting in God and trusting in God's timing, but it's really difficult. It gets really, really hard. We would really love and so appreciate if you could pray for us. Pray for the residency process and just pray for the interview. We would really, really appreciate that. Also, some people might be wondering why I'm not filming this with Gabe. This was something that I really wanted to do by myself, and I feel like because it's sitting so heavy on my heart, it was something that like I had to do by myself, if that makes sense. Like it's like making this video and telling you guys is like lifting a huge weight for me. But also I asked him like if he has anything that he wants to say and anything that he wants to share, because it's also been him going through it too, and kind of him watching me go through it emotionally. I was like, if you have things you want to share as well, you can. But if he does that, I'll let you guys know. It would probably be on our vlog channel. We'll probably sit down together, but I feel like I've forgotten to say so much, but I hope that's answered a lot of your questions. We were actually invited to VidCon Australia, which was like the most exciting thing, and I was so, so excited for it, but obviously we had to say no, which was so sad. I've also been incredibly blessed and invited on some brand trips overseas, which I've said no to as well. I really hope this doesn't come across as ungrateful. Australia is my home, and Australia will always be my home. LA is my home, and Gabriel is my home, but Australia is still home to me. It's really hard not to be able to go back, but we're so excited to, and we talk about it probably every day. We are so excited to go back and to travel around and to go visit my family and all of our friends. We never really got to travel because we moved straight after we got married. Like I so want to travel just all of Australia with him, but for now we don't know when that's gonna be. We have no idea. So yeah, just please pray for us. I love you guys. Thank you for hearing me out and making it this far into the video. I hope you have a good week and a really happy week, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.